Hello, it's Chris here. Our video editor, Adrian, is on vacation. But guess what? I'm not going to let that stop me from answering the question, will AI take over our iOS developer jobs? Now, to give you some context, a couple of weeks ago, I got a question from a mom asking if AI was going to make iOS developers obsolete. Now, you see, she had a son who was interested in programming and she wanted to watch out for him and his future. Totally makes sense. I get it. My first instinct was to reply, nah. Programmers will always be needed, but I had to stop myself because, I mean, AI can do things today that a year ago we didn't think would be possible. So who's to say that in the future, AI won't be able to write an app, an entire app with a single prompt? And guess what? It is kind of possible right now. We'll dive into that a little bit more later in this video, but right now, I want to get back to the story. I really had to give some thought before I responded to this mom, because when I think about it, aren't we moving towards less and less code writing? In recent years, there's more and more no-code solutions to build websites, to build apps, and all those sorts of things. Even Apple is seemingly making this transition to no-code or less code. Think back on the early days of iOS development, and don't worry if you weren't there, because I will paint this picture for you. So we were working with the Objective-C programming language. The syntax was indecipherable. You had to manage your own memory, which means frequent crashes with obscure error messages taking hours to figure out. Oh, and get this. If you think Xcode is bad right now, you weren't there for Xcode version 3. And the Objective-C syntax was more verbose, meaning that you had to write a lot of code just to achieve something very simple, and the keywords, they were obscure. They didn't make sense. If you were missing a dash here or a semicolon there, things would just not work. And then we got Swift. Yay, developers rejoice. I know I certainly did because it made my job teaching beginners a lot easier. Swift took care of a lot of the under the hood nitty gritty details so you didn't have to worry about them. And the syntax was more like natural language and the keywords actually made sense. So that got a lot more people into iOS app development. And then recently we got SwiftUI with its declarative syntax for building user interfaces. You tell the system what you want it to do in various conditions and states, and it does a sensible job of laying things out. You no longer have to write code to tell the system, position this button at X39 and Y100, you know, and you don't have to manually update the views. All of that happens relatively sensibly and relatively well without your intervention. And all of this results in less code needing to be written. So even with Apple, we're moving towards less and less code being written and maybe eventually no code. But you know what? We don't have to guess about what is going to happen because it's already happened in multiple industries time and time again. What do I mean by that? Well, think about car manufacturing plants, factories, manual labor. What happened when robotics got better? Well, I'll leave that thought with you because I want to use an example that's a little bit closer to home. Think about web development. Web development has gone through some form of this transition already because in the early days of the internet, if you wanted to build a website, you needed to know how to code in HTML. And then we got tools such as Dreamweaver to build websites visually, and that made setting up websites a little more accessible to people who didn't know HTML. But what about those people who did know HTML? What happened to them? Well, as the tools got better, web developers had to do less and less of the mundane and repetitive tasks, perhaps to set up the initial frame or scaffolding of the website, and they could focus on creating better websites, more interactive, maybe more visually appealing, maybe better experiences, or perhaps their time was freed up to build even better tools, which then feeds into the loop. As tools get better, then web developers can focus on something else, better experiences, better tools, and then the loop just keeps going on and on. And then if you zoom out and take a look at how websites have evolved, take a modern website versus a website in the early days of the internet, you'll see a dramatic difference. And the same goes for iOS apps. Take a look at early day App Store iOS apps versus the apps of today. So let's bring this back full circle. Will AI replace iOS developers? My personal opinion is that no, it won't. It's just going to redefine what an iOS developer is and what they do. Perhaps there's less of an emphasis on doing the actual coding and more of an emphasis on building a better experience or a more complex and large product. Now take, for example, Vision OS. You know, the goggles that Apple introduced? Not to downplay it, but you know what I mean. Can you imagine building software for that device? Trying to build a spatial experience without any of the tools that Apple provides, or if Apple didn't provide you any tools to do that, it would be a pretty big feat, I think. So it is my belief that AI is a tool that will eliminate a lot of that manual work that iOS developers do and allow us to focus on something farther down the workflow. It won't completely eliminate the need for iOS developers at all. Okay, but I think there's a bigger question here. All of that stuff I just talked about, that was future state. But what can you do right now in preparation to ride the wave and position yourself to be there to take advantage when AI really hits the mainstream? Let's talk about that. And I think I want to address this from two different perspectives. One is from an aspiring or current professional iOS developer. That means you're in the job industry. And the other perspective is from one of being an indie app developer where you're publishing apps and you're making money from the app store. Let's talk about the job industry first. Now, would you agree with me if I said that AI code is cheaper than human code? Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not talking about the AI code of today, which could be insecure, which could be non-contextual to your environment. I'm talking about future state AI code where it's perfected and it is secure and it is contextual and exactly what you need in your organization. Would that be cheaper than humans writing code? And I think the answer is yes. And do we all agree that companies are there to make money? So I think that it makes sense that companies will adopt AI if it helps them make more money and they can figure out what role it plays in their workflow and in their organization. It's just that right now, AI is not 100% there and companies are still figuring out how to use it without having it blow up in their face and costing them tons of dollars and bad PR and ruined reputation. If you are a current iOS professional, chances are you're probably already using generative AI in your workflow, whether or not company policy allows it. If I were still working in industry, I would be really, really tempted. Perhaps to use generative AI for things like writing test cases or documentation or even emails. Or if there's something that I don't know how to do, use AI and try to build it and then read the code and see if I can learn from it. Something like that. If you're smart about it, I feel like you would use generative AI as a draft, as a starting point, and then you would filter that output through your own expertise rather than fully trusting it, generating it, and then submitting it. I think you can get into a lot of trouble like that. Now, if you do a good job of using AI in your workflow right now, I bet you're probably pretty productive, much more so than your peers who are not using generative AI in their workflow. Now, just be careful because you might be playing with fire if it's not allowed in your company and you are doing it. As an aspiring iOS professional, I think the decision is a lot more easy here. If I were you, I would keep a pulse on the AI industry and how tools are evolving, how good they're getting, so that when companies do understand how AI plays a role in their organization, you'll be there and you'll have a leg up against all of the other candidates who have not looked at AI at all. Now let's talk about indie app developers. Oh boy, I think you guys are on a gold mine. Let me tell you why. If you make money from publishing apps, I think AI tools have just supercharged your workflow. More and more frequently, I'm seeing posts like this pop up on Reddit where someone has released full-fledged apps or products generated by AI and they're getting users and they're getting revenue, but they have no idea how to code and what any of it does. They just generate it and publish it, market it. The problem is when they hit a snag such as this, they don't know how to fix it because they have no technical knowledge. But if you are an indie app dev, you do have that knowledge. And you also have no company policy telling you that you cannot use AI. There are no rules. So you could very well use AI to generate you apps tweak it, modify it, and publish it. And that is so much faster than building your own apps from scratch. Another thing, content-based apps. As a solo developer, it's really hard to create content-based apps because you need a lot of content and you probably need a team to create all of this content. That's where the value of a content-based app is. But with AI, do I have to connect the dots for you? Anyways, I think it's a great time to capitalize on the App Store. And I think that as more apps get published, things will get more competitive and you'll have to stand out from that. The same thing happened in the web dev industry. As websites became easier and easier to build, there were so many tools. You could just set up a website with no knowledge of code at all. It just became more competitive and websites needed to become better if you wanted to stand out from the crowd. It needed to provide a better experience, I mean. Now, for me personally, I'm late to the game. I haven't explored AI tools yet, but as we are working on this mood tracker app, and it's back on, by the way, so I'm excited to share more updates with you going forward. But as we are continuing to work on this mood tracker app, I'm very interested in diving into AI tools to see how it can improve and speed up that workflow. And I'll definitely share all of my experiences and learnings with you through YouTube here. So to wrap it up, I want to turn over to you. What do you personally think AI will do to iOS development? Do you agree with me? Do you disagree with me? I look forward to reading your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Thanks for chatting with me. I'll see you in the next video.